Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about white box testing. So white box testing is generally for part of software testing process. So here we'll see what is white box testing, what do we verify in white box testing, how do we perform it, types of white box testing, their techniques, testing tools, and their advantages and disadvantages. So if you are watching this channel first time and you want to learn about software testing, then please watch my complete software testing playlist. Now, coming down to the white box testing. White box testing is trying method where programming inward constructions, plan and coding are tried to check input yield stream and further develop plan, convenience and security. In white box testing, code is apparent to analyzers, so it's additionally called clear box testing. Open box testing on straightforward box testing, code-based testing, and glass box testing. Generally, in white box testing, we are doing the testing on code. We are analyzing the code so that there would be not having any defect in productions. It is one of two pieces of the case testing we to deal with programming testing. Here we will verify each and every aspects of the coding so that we can find out the defects or remove the error from the program. The expression white box was utilized due to the transparent box idea. The unmistakable box or white box name represents the capacity to see though the product's external cell into its inward functions. So what do we verify in white box testing? Generally here we are verifying the security openings. So if we have any loopholes which might impact into our system or might corrupt our system, or intruder will get inside the system. So here verifying the security aspects. Broken and ineffectively organized way in the coding process. So let's say coder has written functions which is not closed at the ending. So that is a part of white box testing. If any parentheses are missing, semicolons are missing, or maybe some arguments are not proper. So we are verifying these broken areas of code. The progressions of explicit contributions through the code. Generally here we are analyzing the complete code structure so that at the time of executions or at the time of running we cannot get any junk value. That should be as per the expectations. Anticipated yields if we have. Usefulness of contingent circles. So let's say we have five functions and we are not using one of the functions, so there is a new use within the code, so we can remove that if we are not utilizing the code in future. So generally we are removing some of the coding structure which is not at all required. Testing of every assertion, item and capability on a single premise. The testing should be possible at framework, mix and unit level of the programming advancement. Here we are also verifying the unit level of the testing. Each and every aspects of the code to be tested, that is called as white box testing. Here we are verifying the functionality for an application. It can include testing progressions of predefined input against expected or wanted yield, so that when a particular information does not bring about the normal results, we have experienced a bug. How do we perform this type of testing? Generally, there are two methods to perform the white box testing. One is understand the source code, and second is create test cases and execute. So let's say we have a structure of code which is designed, and that code is having 5,000 lines of the code. So here, first we have to understand which logic is working for which functionality. Then we are removing the redundant data if that is available within the code, and after understanding the source code we are easily able to test it that applications. If we are just looking on the top of this, it's definitely going to kill lots of our time. But if we have the complete structure understanding of the code, generally that will become very easy to test any applications or any code. Second is to create a test cases and execute. So in this step, we are generally writing the test cases of each and every steps and verifying it thoroughly. Probably this second step will be used for the senior level people who will create the test cases, and someone else who is from the junior level, they will execute the test cases. So this will be done by two person. Now to understand the source code, let's understand in detail. So primary thing of analyzing will frequently to learn and comprehend the source code of the applications. Since white box testing includes the testing of the inward functions of an application, the analyzer should be truly educated in the programming dialects utilized in the application they are trying. Likewise, the testing individual should be exceptionally mindful of secure coding rehearses. Security is many times one of the essential targets of any testing programming. If you are taking care of any W3 security mechanism, then we have to take care of each and every. There should be no loophole to get invitations to the interior to inside the system. Analyzers ought to have the options to find security issues and keep assaults from the programmers and innocent clients who could infuse code into the application either purposely or unwittingly. Now, second steps to create and execute test cases. As I discussed, the subsequent fundamental stages to white box testing include testing the application of source code in legitimate stream and design. Generally, here we are writing the test cases on each and every cycle and series of the cycle of an applications. Different strategies incorporate manual testing, preliminary and mistakes testing, and the utilizations of testing devices, as well as we can make sense of additionals on this content. So which all types of white box testing we have? First is unit testing. So here, first, we are verifying each and every unit of the code, a block and the structure, functions, arguments. So these all data we are verifying inside the program. Second is testing for memory leaks. Generally, memory leaks are leading cause of slower running applications. As a QA specialist, whoever is having experience at detecting memory leaks is essential in case where we have slow running software applications. Then white box penetration testings. This is the one of the important part of any applications, and here we are verifying the source code, detailed network informations, IP addresses involved, and all the server informations as well as TTL certificates. So if we are fine with that, then only we are passing the step. Then white box mutation testings. Again, this is an important testing aspects used to discover the best coding techniques. If you have followed any redundant data, or maybe we have lots of variable which we have not used, then we have to remove it from the code. Which all techniques we have for the white box testing? So white box testing can be performed on different stages. First is statement coverage. Statement coverage, it means we are verifying each and every line of the code which examines out all the holes in an experiment suits. Decision coverage, then branch coverage, from we are verifying from start to end of the branch. Then the condition is proper or not. If we are verifying the conditions, generally we are verifying in terms of value as well. So if we are passing the value which does not give the accurate answer, then probably we have to change the data as well. Multiple condition coverage, then finite state machine coverage. Path coverage, here we are verifying each and every path. Normally here we are verifying the navigations as well. Control flow testings and data flow testings are the part of white box testing techniques. Now, which all techniques tool or white box testing tools we have? There are lots of tools available in the market, but I listed down five. That is, one is ECL EMMA, N unit, PY unit, HTML unit, and CPP unit. There are several other white box testing tools are available which we can use it. It's totally up to us or our organizations and team structure. So how we are using this? Sometimes people are running into Visual Studio Code or some Eclipse and all. So, but it's totally up to us how we can verify the code. So which are advantages and disadvantages of white box testing we have? So white box testings is an enhancement by tracking down secret mistakes. White box test cases can be handily robotized. Testing is more exhaustive as all code ways are generally covered. Testing can be begin from the get-to-go in SDLC, regardless of whether GUI isn't accessible. So which are these advantages of white box testing we have? So white box testing can be very mind-boggling and costly. Designers who, as a rule, execute white box experiments hate it. The white box testing by designers isn't itemized and can prompt creation mistakes. White box testing requires proficient assets with an itemized comprehensions of programming and executions. And finally, white box testing is tedious. Greater programming application gets some margins to completely test it. And very important part, sometimes developer itself who is doing this testing, and generally they are focusing on the development side of it. So probably they will not catch all the defects, which can be reproducible in further part of the testing process. So that's all from this video. Let's recap it. We have started with the introduction of white box testing. Then we have discussed about what is white box testing and their techniques. Then the tools as well as the advantages and disadvantages. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.